How's it going? This is Robert Dempsey, CEO and founder of Dempsey Marketing, and I wanted to do a quick overview of Stanzer, which is going to be the platform that we're using for the weekly Dempsey Marketing chat. Now, I'm already logged into an existing chat, a speaker chat, which is talking about how to get a speaking calendar booked full. Pretty great chat going on right now. We see we got 29 people in this chat. Now, I'll be giving you the URL to get into the Dempsey Marketing chat, but when you get there, just so you know, there are a few ways that you can actually log into the chat and start participating. So we have a login up here at the top right, which is if you already have a Stanzer account. However, you do not need one in order to participate in the chat. You can basically just sign up here. You can use LinkedIn, Twitter, or Facebook and get right in. I would suggest probably just using Twitter if you want to use the Twitter integration functionality that Stanzer has. Now, let me take you over to Firefox I'm on Firefox here just so I can show you the sign up. I'm gonna pop over to Google Chrome right now where the chat is already in progress. Now, what occurred here is that basically Stanzer has this very interesting UI user interface where you can have multiple topics. So right now there's actually multiple topics here that they have created for this chat. Now with the Dempsey Marketing chat, I think we might just stick to one topic for now, keep it simple. But either way, they do have the topic up here. We have like what the question is, a little background on it, etc. And then there's a little arrow up here. So if you're ever on a chat in Stanzer and they say, hey, let's switch to the next topic, this is the arrow up here that you want to click to go to the next topic. So it actually looks like we're on the third topic over here of this chat. And so not going to really get into the explanation of why that's there, but basically, I will just real quickly. Basically, I think if for a chat moderator, if you want to kind of keep all the conversations separate, then you can absolutely do that here. Now, it does show you some additional items on Stanzer. Number one, right, we have the title of the chat itself. Again, this one is how to get a speaking calendar booked full. We have the hashtag, which is pretty typical for a Twitter chat. You can add the chat to your calendar. It also says who's moderating it. You can send a message to the people that are moderating it. And we have, you know, scheduled for, telling you in military time, or rather, I guess, European time, really, is what a lot of people use there for the 24-hour system instead of just the 12 hours that we typically use in the US. You can like the chat, tweet it, share it on LinkedIn, email. This is some branding here for the moderators that Stanzer has available to you. So for instance, this one is talking about the guest, which is Jay Handler. He's offering a ton of great tips for speakers to get gigs, getting paid for speaking, etc. In the chat itself. So that's what this left column is for. Now the main chat is going on here in the middle, and you can see who is saying what. You can reply to a specific person by clicking the little arrow. You can thumb up a chat message if you want. You can also share the stanza. They call it a stanza, basically one of these messages. You can share that as well. Now, one thing I want to note, a big note here, and the reason that I'm using Stanzer in the first place rather than using a standard Twitter chat is because I didn't want to flood my Twitter community with messages that are meaningless to them, right? They completely lack context. If I am in a chat and all of a sudden I'm sending out all these tweets with these hashtags and they're like, what the hell is going on? So in order to avoid that, that's where Stanzer really comes in big time. And there's a checkbox here that is checked by default, actually, and this is auto post on Twitter, and it'll append the hashtag to the tweet every time that you put it in there. Now, if you don't want to send all of these tweets out to Twitter, definitely uncheck that box. I have already unchecked it, which is why it's unchecked. However, when you do first log into Stanzer and get into a chat, it will be checked. Now, some really cool stuff I think that separates Stanzer also from some of the other platforms. First off, you can see, you know, who is in the chat. We can see that there's 29 different people in the chat. Sorry. Every time you hover over someone, it'll pop up, you know, their name. You can send them a message. You can click here on their name and head over to Twitter. Follow them there. See recent tweets. You can hide everything else except seeing who's in the chat. That's a very cool feature there. Also, this is some really neat stuff right here. Now, you can see the stanzas that people like the most. So really, what's getting the attention inside of the chat. And also, this is a really big one for me, compared to a lot of the tweet chat tools that are out there, you can also see who is replying to you, quickly reply to them, share it, give it a thumbs up. That makes it so much easier to be able to kind of have a mini conversation, if you will, with someone inside of the main chat itself. And when you click again, these little arrows, it'll expand that one section, and then you just click it again, and so then you can see everybody once more. So that is Stanzer in a nutshell. I look forward to seeing you on the Dempsey Marketing chat. We're gonna be live Tuesday the 25th, which for me is today, which for you when you're watching this video might be today, but you can join us every Tuesday night at 9 p.m. Eastern time. You'll see the link below in this video. It'll also be on the blog post that I create for it as well. So hope to see you there. I'm Robert Dempsey with Dempsey Marketing. Have a great one. Bye-bye.